Hey everyone, it's Sheena Fitzay, Start Determined and Satisfied, also known as just Sheena. Today's day 349. Oh wow, that means tomorrow's day 350. Wow. Day 349, that means 16 days until I hit my year on my lifestyle change. I'm feeling good. Last week, I don't know. Maybe it's whenever I like deprive myself or restrict myself, then I have a couple days of when I just want to eat things. I don't really know. Like maybe it was a smoothie challenge. And then sometimes I think maybe I just think about certain things too much. Like I just felt like I was doing so bad in so many days because I did. Like I went to Fridays, I had chips, I had cookies, you know, and I was eating a lot of bad things, but I was still working out. But at the end of the day, like, I got on a scale this morning, and I was 167. So it's like, I ain't gaining weight. Like, you don't have to be perfect. You just got to keep making the right decisions. And even if you keep messing up, like, I kept messing up, you know, not messing up, but eating the wrong things when I know I shouldn't. Eating Snickers and eating Doritos and eating Popeyes and all this other crap. But it's like, before, the Sheena that used to go on all these diets, like, the minute she did that, she would quit and then go right back to her unhealthy lifestyle. But now with this lifestyle, it's not about that. It's like, okay, I ate something, I know I shouldn't eat it, and I move on, and tomorrow I'm gonna do better. This week I follow Dawn. I don't know if you guys follow her. She's on Instagram. Her name is Dawn Esteller. Did I say it right? I love her. She does this whole sweat workout routine, and I've been following her on Instagram since the beginning of my journey. I actually have a video of me doing one of her videos, her workout DVDs, and she came to New York one time on her sweat tour, and I went to New York City and I participated in the sweat class. So I saw she was doing this program this week called Just Live. It was $7, and it's like it's not a program, it's more like just more a mental process thing. That's what I needed help with, you know. Even though I'm on my 11th month on my journey, I'm almost at a year, I still struggle, you know. I still have that battle with food. Not everything's gonna change in a year. Like I told you guys, I've been unhealthy. I've been overweight for most of my life. You know, I didn't really eat vegetables. I didn't eat fruit. You know, I didn't drink any water. So yeah, I made a lot of changes, but that doesn't mean all those battles in my head just go away. Like, you know, there's still those times where I'm telling myself, like, you don't need to eat that. You're not hungry. You just ate something. Like Saturday, we went out for my boyfriend's birthday. And I stopped at the Chinese place and I got fried chicken wings and fried plantain. I didn't eat all of it, but I ate some of it before I went out. And then when we came home that night, he got Taco Bell and I got a Dorito taco. And it's like, it's not the worst thing. I could have ordered more. I wanted to order more, but it was like, was I really hungry where I needed to order that taco? Or did I just want it? And I think I just wanted it. It wasn't something I need. So that's what I mean when I say, like, eating bad or doing things. It's not like I'm not on a diet. It's a lifestyle change. So sometimes you're going to eat things that are not 100% healthy. But when you're eating something and you know you're not even really hungry, or you know it's late, or you know you're going to sleep, it's like at that point you're just doing it to do it. You're not doing it to fuel your body. So I guess the next couple of months is just, you know, what Dawn was showing me, you know, just thinking about food more as fuel to fuel your body, not something that's going to make you happy, not something that's good. And I was explaining to her how, you know, I still have that thing in my head where I look at bad food as the good food that I shouldn't be eating a lot. Like, there's some people that look at, like, McDonald's and Checkers, and they're like, oh, that's just disgusting. A lot of times I look at things and I'll think, please, that's like 600 calories, you know. But it's hard because I'm different. You know, I'm much better than the Sheena I was last year, but I still have a lot to work on mentally. This journey is not just about what you eat and, you know, working out. You gotta get your mind right, because, you know, like they say, if you believe, that's when it's gonna happen. So when you're telling yourself, you know, the reasons of why you shouldn't eat something or whatever, I don't know. She gave us some pointers of what we should do, and I wrote out a list of things that keep me happy and things I could do. So the next time I have this crave of I'm gonna eat something when I know I'm not even hungry and I know I shouldn't have it, instead of just keep talking to myself, sorry, phone's ringing. Telling myself why I shouldn't have it, I'm gonna go and do one of these things on the list. And after I do it, figure out, do you still want to eat that? Take the time. Like, don't just eat it just to eat it. You know, yes, this is a lifestyle change. It's not a diet, But you know when you're, there's a difference between depriving yourself or something and just being greedy and just wanting to eat crab just because you want to eat it. So that was a struggle. But this week's going good. Today's Tuesday, so it's only day two. But I made a schedule. Like every day I gave myself a goal to meet at the gym. Because I'm more of like that random workout, just go and do something and whatever happens, happens. I don't really have like leg day, arm day, this exercise day. It's just go to the gym day. So Monday I said my goal was to drink, you know, my 120 ounces of water as usual and to be at the gym at 6:30 and to burn at least 600 calories. So Monday I did beat my goal. I burned almost 800 calories. Today's calorie goal was 500 and I was above the 500 mark. I did the stairs. You know, a couple months ago, I lasted like 5 minutes on the stairs, and yesterday I did an hour, today I did 40 minutes, so just there you can see progress there. It's not always just about the pounds, it's about doing things that you couldn't do before, you know, or you thought you couldn't do it. I was just so against those stairs until I actually said, no, you're going to do this, and now I do it. I'm kind of slacking on my water, but yesterday I did finish my gallon. Today I'm kind of slow on it, but I will finish it, speak it into existence. That's it. I wanted to give you guys... Oh, yeah. I made chili last night for dinner. I had it with some white rice, a cup of chili and a cup of white rice. And then I made 2 cups with no rice for lunch today and lunch tomorrow. So I just finished eating that chili, so that was pretty good. And breakfast, I had a smoothie. It was leftover. I'm not sure I made these, so it wasn't the best smoothie, but I drank it. I feel like making another one. That's it. 16 more days until I hit my year. You know, I'm trying to focus less on what the scale is, and that's why I did not upload the Face the Scale Friday. Sometimes just keep saying, oh, I want to hit this number, I want to hit this number, I want to hit this number. It's like your mind is just so focused on this number, and that's when I start having these battles of what I want to eat and what I'm not going to eat. So yeah, I still weigh in at home in the morning, whatever, but I'm not tripping, you know, till Thanksgiving's on Thursday, but I have a plan and I'm going to stick with it. Like, I'm going to enjoy my time with my family. I'm going to eat food. I'm not going to just overstuff myself to the point where I can't even move. But I'm not going to be like, oh, I'm on a lifestyle change. I can't have it. No. You know, this is a lifestyle change. So some days you're just going to eat bad. So then tomorrow my goal is 600 calories. And then I'm doing a 5-mile run Thanksgiving morning. So I don't know how many calories. I didn't have a calorie goal. Just whatever I burn there. And then on Friday, I have a 500-calorie goal, Saturday a 300-calorie goal, and Sunday 550. So every day it ranged between burning 500 to 600 calories per the workout. I didn't put the actual time, so whether it takes me an hour or it takes me an hour and a half or 2 hours, as long as I reach my calorie burn, I got it. So I plan to basically work out every day this week, even Thanksgiving. I'm going to earn that extra meal. And then I'll tell you guys next week, you know, how it goes from there. I'm not sure if I'll be doing the Face the Scale Friday because it is a day after Thanksgiving. But it's one day. It's not the whole month. You know, it's just one day to eat good, to be with your family. Don't go crazy. And that's what I'm going to tell myself. I told myself, have fun, eat good, just don't go crazy. That's what my book says. And then Friday I'm off, but I'll be at that gym. I'll probably even burn more than 500. Unless I'm like really feeling lazy from Thanksgiving. All right, it's Sheena Fitzay. Just wanted to give you guys a recap on my journey. Oh, and one more thing. I'm going to show you guys a picture after this. If you guys are not on Instagram, I wanted to show you guys too. My mom took a picture of me day one of my journey. And I was in my sports bra and my underwears. And I remember her asking me, are you going to post that? And I'm like, hell no. Like maybe in the future when I lose weight and stuff, but... And even now, I wasn't ready to post it because it's just out there. It's like, that's your body to see. There's no clothes hiding. There's no cropping a photo and making you look thinner. It's just you. So I was planning to post it when I hit 100 pounds lost because I thought at least then there'll be a big enough difference so I wouldn't be as bad. But yesterday, I posted it. And I said, you know what? I don't care. That's me. Love your body at any size. And I don't look like that anymore. I did a lot of hard work to get away from there. And I never want to go back. So I just want to show people that picture and keep, you know, if that motivates others and lets them know that they can do it too, you know, that's great. I've, like, my followers from Instagram went from, like, 1,000 to 2,000, over 2,000, like, in the past month. It's crazy. And I get all these comments and, you know, keeks and emails. And I just love it because it motivates me to keep on going because other people see me as the inspiration. They're asking me how I did it there. And that was me, like, less than freaking a year ago. Like, in November of 2013, I still wasn't on my lifestyle change. I was still 250-plus pounds. I was still eating whatever the hell I wanted to eat. And I was the one out there looking for, you know, that support, that direction, that what should I do? How do I start this? And it's crazy that now this year there's people coming to me and asking me, what did I do and how do I do it? And it feels great. And I wish, like, people ask me what I like, and I feel like what's crazy is this lifestyle, this community, this, you know, helping people, I wish it could be, like, a permanent thing, because I just love it. Like, it's what I like. I love being on Instagram. I love being on YouTube. I love hearing people say that I'm making them feel that they can make a difference, because there's nothing special about me. Like, yeah, I'm special because I'm Sheena, but what I mean by that is it. If I could do it, you can too. Like, I spent my whole life being overweight. Like, and I cheat here and there. I eat bad. It's not like I'm eating, you know, leaves all day long. So if I could still be cheating here and there, getting my workout in and just being persistent and consistent and lose almost, you know, 90 pounds, then you could do it. Like, you just have to believe in yourself. Say, you know what, today I'm starting my journey. I'm going to do it. I'm losing this much, you know, I'm going to be healthy. And I'm going to live this life, and I'm never going to go back, and I'm not going to accept any excuses. Not that you're tired. That I went to sleep almost 1 o'clock in the morning. I was still up at 6:30, because it's like, listen, you can sleep more. But that feeling when I leave the gym, and it's morning time, about to head to work, and I just burned over 500 calories, it feels freaking great. So it's like, get out your bed, Sheena, and go. And I got like 3 more weeks until school ends, and then I'll be graduated with my MBA, and then it's really operation just focus on me, my family, and then, you know, I'm going to start couponing. It's going to be my new hobby, because I'm tired of living, you know, paycheck to paycheck, and I feel like if I can speak it to existence this year and lose a freak 100 pounds, I could do anything. So 2015, I'm about to get it together financially and figure out my life and pay these student loans back and figure out what I want to do, because losing this weight taught me that I really can do anything I want. So, you know, who knows what's going to happen in 2015, but I'm looking forward to it. And if you guys haven't started planning your 2015, you're behind. You'll be planning. I'm planning my races. I'm looking forward to this. All right, I'm about to go back inside. Sheena Fitzay, don't forget to like and subscribe and tell your friends. Hit me on Instagram. Start Determined _ _ and Satisfied on Instagram. Bye.